Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to tonight's Veterans Day concert put on by the Lakeside High School Wind Ensemble along with the First Baptist Church North Augusta Choir. Tonight's concert opened with a classic Carmen Dragon arrangement of America the Beautiful. Originally written for orchestra in 1963, Mr. Dragon later reorchestrated the piece for symphonic band. It has since become one of the most iconic and widely played pieces of concert band music in the repertoire, patriotic or not. Now please rise for the playing of our national anthem. Some claim that the river and valley were named in the 1750s by the Cherokee as a friendly tribute to a visiting Iroquois chief named Shenandoah. Others suggest that the region was named not by the Cherokee, but by the Shenandoah Indians of Virginia Valley. In the Shenandoah tradition, Shenandoah means daughter of the moon and bears no relation to the Iroquois chief Shenandoah. The origins of the folk song are equally obscure, but all date to the 19th century. It has been attributed variously to a coal miner in Pennsylvania, to a young protege of Stephen Foster, and to a housewife in Lexington, Kentucky. Many variants of the melody and text have been handed down through the years, the most popular telling the story of an early settler's love for a Native American woman. In my study of Shenandoah, I was inspired by the freedom and beauty of the folk melody and by the natural images evoked by the words, especially the image of a river. I was less concerned with the sound of a rolling river than with its life-affirming energy, its timelessness. Sometimes the accompaniment flows quietly under the melody, other times it breathes alongside it. The work's mood ranges from quiet reflection through growing optimism to profound exaltation. Frank Tekeli's Shenandoah.
Thank you.
an Appalachian folk hymn in the 19th century. The exact roots of the song are unknown, but the earliest printed version is found in the 1867 book entitled Slave Songs of the United States, under the title The Good Old Way. Slave used the song as a prayer for guidance, and the lines Down the River and Starry Crown are attributed to the coded language of the Underground Railroad. Runaway slaves would travel in the river to mask their scent from hunting dogs and use the stars for navigation on their journey. The unmistakable melody has since been featured in hymnals, spiritual collections, and movie soundtracks, perhaps most notably in the film O Brother, Where Art Thou? Lakeside Lived Ensemble performs for you this African American spiritual, Down in the River.
Thank you.
ask that all veterans stand as you are able whenever your branch of song is played. Thank you.
1996, this iconic march has become one of America's most popular and enduring musical symbols of patriotism. The Lakeside Ensemble of Sousa's Stars and Stripes Forever.
He's taken over the high school as a head director, and I thank him for his hard work
is, he puts a lot of thought in everything that he does, has done a phenomenal job, and it makes me proud to come back and be able to be the narrator for this fine group. So thank you, Mr. Jared Best, for your hard work. I appreciate it. She's phenomenal to work with, and when we asked her if we could get the choir to join us again, it's been a couple of years since we've been able to do this. She was very much, we're in the midst of working on a huge Christmas program, December 9th and 10th, and so we took some time out of our schedule and practices to work this song out for you. So as we close tonight, I just want to thank you all for attending the concert tonight. It's wonderful for our students and our community to begin to experience live music again. We've missed this a lot. For our finale this evening, we are excited to once again collaborate with First Baptist Church Choir of North Augusta after a two-year hiatus because of that COVID-19 pandemic. Feel free to sing along, clap along, as you enjoy our rendition of God Loves America.